Hello everyone, welcome back to Naughty Threads. In today's video, I'm going to unbox this J820 from Brother, which is a very basic sewing machine. So we'll see what are the features it has and how much it will cost and what all you can do if you buy this for yourself. So this is the machine. It says it is, it comes along with an instructional DVD. If you want, you can, watch the complete DVD. Now, this machine has a top load bobbin, which means there is no need of any bobbin case. And then it says free arm for sewing cuffs and sleeves. It also has an LED lighting with adjustable stitch width and length. So it is from the same brand, Brother. The one I have, but mine is a little advanced model. That particular model they are not producing anymore, it's not in production anymore. So I picked this up for my tailoring classes. These are the machines the students will be getting to learn on. So it just comes with two pressure foots. That is, one is a regular foot for sewing and the other one is the pico foot. So with this machine you can do zigzag or pico along with sewing your normal stuff. So now let's just turn around and see what else it has. Brother is a very reliable brand, so that is why I decided, after doing quite a bit of research, I was actually confused which one to pick up, either Usha or Brother, but then I decided to go with Brother because of its brand value. Yeah, I think the same thing is mentioned over here. This is the zigzag foot. I think it also has a zipper foot. I have not opened the box yet. I have just picked it up yesterday. I wanted to do the unboxing along with you guys, so I have not opened it yet. It is completely sealed. It comes with a bobbin needle set, which will have two pieces extra. And then it also has a darning plate, screwdriver, foot controller and instructionals, instructional DVD. So all these are included in the accessories, as you can see on the screen. You can do very basic sewing with this. You can sew dresses for yourself, you can sew such drawstring bags, some tote bags. So these are the kind of built-in stitches it has. This is just a straight stitch but with left alignment. This is the center alignment and this is the right alignment. Usually these three will be there in all basic machines. And then it has this zigzag stitch. If you just use the normal foot and set it to zigzag stitch, it will just stitch zigzag in a flat on the fabric. But instead, if you are using it with a pico foot, then it'll actually roll the fabric and do zigzag. So this is how the machine is. If you are just starting to learn tailoring, I think this is one of the best choice. It comes with 2-year warranty as well. So now I'm going to unbox it and let's see how it looks in real. So now let's cut open the seal. So here is the accessories pack. So it actually comes with a handle like this to hold and move the machine, since it is a portable one. So in this pack I have the warranty card, the warranty details and the other bills and all of that related to machine. So as of now this is not required, so I'm going to put it back in the box. So we'll see on what all this pouch contains, and then we will also see how this machine runs. I'm just going to remove the plastic. This is actually the putter tape, so I'm going to remove that. First, we'll see what this accessory kit contains. Okay, so this one is a seam ripper. Most of you would know this is used to remove the stitches. And then it has two bobbins, plastic bobbins. Like already mentioned, this machine will not need any kind of bobbin case. Okay, so this one is the zigzag foot, which has this rolled metal piece here. The normal pressure foot is already installed on the machine, and this one is a zipper foot. This is a darning plate. I'm not really sure because I have not got this one in my machine. So let me see how we can use this. I will first figure that out and then share it with you guys. And this is a small screwdriver to loosen the screws. And it has a needle pack with two needles. So like mentioned on the box, the kit has everything. I'm just going to put everything back and then we'll move on to the machine. This is the regular foot that is already installed on the machine here. And it also has a pre-installed needle. So first we will connect the foot controller, which is here in the cover. I'll just remove it from the cover and we'll connect it. So the power plug I have already connected to its place. This one goes in here, which has a 3-pin. So just check the direction, because this one side is completely plain and the other side has this ridge. So just double check before you are connecting it. So now our foot controller is also connected. This is the foot controller. So I'm going to place it down on the floor. The cable also is pretty much, it's long enough. So let's switch it on. There is also a power switch here, a small switch where you can turn the machine on and off. So now the machine is on. You can see the LED light, which will actually be very useful when you are sewing small projects. So we'll start off with the bobbin here. You just have to slide this plate to get the bobbin out. And here is your bobbin. Since it's a top load, there is no need of bobbin case, unlike in most of the other machines. And we'll just have to press this back to close the plate. you have to hear that click noise. In case it clicks, then it means it is locked. So this is where the bobbin goes. In most of the machines it is here below, but for all brother models it is top load. And here the needle is already installed, so I'm not going to mess around with that. You will have to pull this lever, this one on top, to lift the pressure foot. And there is a button here at the back, this black one here. When you press it, it will eject the foot. So to fix the foot, all you have to do is pull the lever down and it will fix it. It's very simple. So that's about the bobbin case and the pressure foot. You eject it and you can install another pressure foot like Pico foot and continue. Next, moving on to these knobs or thing here. This is to adjust the stitch. So like already discussed, this has like four different types of stitches. One is the regular zigzag, little wider zigzag, and then this is the needle alignment. One is towards its left center and towards the right. Here you can also change the stitch length or width. Both these knobs will move, so you can set it accordingly. And then this one here is to do the locking. Usually when we start sewing something, we tend to lock it. So in this machine it is done using this button here. Otherwise in regular machines, we just have to manually move the fabric to and fro to lock. This is another knob here to lift the needle up and down. So this also moves. So yeah, that's about it here. And there is one compartment here. This also you just have to slide it like this to get it out. I've put my accessories kit in here so that it is safe and we don't lose anything. You'll have to install it also in the same way. That's it. And then coming to this part, the thread part. This is where you will install the thread. It will go down and when you pull it, it will kind of get extended, and this is where you will install it. So this is for the thread spool and this is to wind the bobbin. This will actually get locked. This is exactly how it looks on my machine, and then you press it on the other side to release it. So while loading the bobbin, how the thread has to pass is very nicely represented here on the machine itself. So if you are a beginner, this is very helpful. And here you can see how to thread the machine for normal sewing. So numbers are given here. So this is 2, 3 and 4. 3 is actually down here. So that's how we will thread the machine. In the side here, it also has this small blade which will help you cut the thread. This blade here, if you can see. This is also there in my machine. So on the whole, this is how it is. So here are the two machines I picked up for my classes. I have unboxed one and the other one is still there because we have not started. I am going to unbox it later. And very soon I will make a detailed video on how to use the machine and how to take care of it. Unlike other machines, this doesn't need frequent oiling or anything of that sort. When it comes to maintenance, it's very easy. You just have to maintain the machine clean and that's about it. I think I already mentioned this machine comes with 2 years warranty from Brother, so you can get it repaired at any Brother authorized repair shop free of cost. So yeah, that's about it for today then. I hope you guys like this video. In case you did, please give us a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Keep sharing our videos with your friends and continue supporting us. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our other channel, which is Naughty Vlogs. And yeah, that's about it. I will see you soon in my next video. Until then, take care, guys. Bye-bye.